I think what you're likely to see is this president kind of live tweeting this entire campaign, watching all of the debates, injecting himself a lot. And I think in part of that is going to give Democratic voters interesting information about who can and can't stand up to the scrutiny and the attacks and the trolling. Mm. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me. For example, the New York Times today has reported an anecdote about Senator Amy Klobuchar involving her eating a salad with a hair comb and requiring a staffer to clean it. Think about the nicknames that might spawn. And all of these people are going to have some kind of cute nickname from the president, some kind of thing he's trying to do to undermine them. Seeing if they're able to overcome it and fight back in a way Elizabeth Warren has not been able to with regards to the Native American heritage story, I think is going to be something Democratic voters will be looking at. Can you stand up to the nickname?
And let me just get our viewers up to speed a bit, and I'll come to you, Jamal, which is in the story, the New York Times reports, that a staffer forgot to bring her the fork, the plastic fork with the salad. She ate it with the comb because she didn't have any other instrument. And then she berated him and told him to clean the comb. But here's the larger point in this New York Times story. What happened next was typical. Ms. Klobuchar berated her aide instantly for the slip-up. What happened after that was not. She pulled a comb from her bag and began eating the salad with it, according to four people familiar with the episode. Then she handed the comb over to her staff member with a directive, clean it. There has been these stories dogging her in the press that she admits, she says she's a tough boss, she demands a lot of her staffers, but she also demands a lot of herself, demands a lot from the country. Is this something that could actually hurt her with voters, do you think?
I don't think voters really care that much. I mean, unless it shows up in a way that impacts them, somebody they care about, or something that's really bad. We find some old photo that we all care about. Other than that, how staff are treated is not how voters choose a president. One of the smartest things that I've heard someone say is someone who won the president twice, President Barack Obama, about how you run. We usually think of this as a marathon, but President Obama would say it's more like a decathlon, and there are 10 different events, and you don't have to win every event, but you've got to do well. The ones you do really well in, you got to smoke people, and the ones you're not so great in, don't get smoked, right? The Donald Trump trolling is now a new event in the decathlon when you run for president.
How they deal with it.
How you handle the Donald Trump trolling. And Trump should be careful. The president should be careful, because if Democrats had to choose a nominee a couple of years ago, we would have probably thought he was the one that we wanted out of that pack. He should be careful who he tries to choose, because it might be the person who is best suited to be him.
But let me ask you, do you think at this point, we've been reading these tweets now at least since 2015, do you think at this point the sting is out of him? That he defines people, he attacks them, but he called Senator Bernie Sanders a crazy Bernie the other day. It really didn't make much of an impact. He's already a defined known quality.
Right.
But do you think that his tweets, like, you know, when he's low energy Jeb, pack the same punch that they did in 2015?
I think there's diminishing returns. I think it was also more fun for many in media to cover it when it was a Republican on Republican action than it will be for Trump going after them. But it does. It just takes up energy, and it takes up air in the room. And it will do that regardless, because his tweets, as much as I dislike it, are just newsworthy because they're the president speaking. And so that will be part of it. And one of his greatest talents, I left this off the list, is that he can make people as crazy as he is, right?
He
turns people up.
Yeah.
And so
if you
become that person,
don't wrestle with it.
As Kristen said, Democratic voters need to know that.
And the Democrats are trying to avoid talking about his tweets and trying to focus on the issues they want to talk about. Democratic candidate Julian Castro, the former HUD secretary, criticized the president this morning when discussing the first thing he would do if he were elected. Take a listen.
The first thing I would do is repair the alliances that this president is tearing apart. You know, there are alliances like NATO and our friendship with European countries that have helped keep the United States safer post-World War II. And this president has kept our allies out of the loop.
Is that effective? I mean, President Trump isn't targeting him yet, but is that effective to talk about these issues on the stump, talk about things like that, as opposed to responding, as a lot of Republicans did when they ran against Trump last time, to the tweets?
Well, we're talking about him, and he is not currently a top-tier candidate. So that means it is effective, because people are looking at him. They may not know him, and he's talking about a serious issue, which is our relationships overseas. So that is winning for him, I think.